Hey, welcome to another video. Today's video is about, will my life improve because I've stopped drinking alcohol? You know, I can't tell you that. You know, the likelihood is that it will. Think of leaving the alcohol behind you as a starting post. You know, what you do next, where you go next, what changes you make in your mind, what changes you make in your life after you stop. That is what's going to decide if your life improves, or if it's going to improve once you stop drinking alcohol, right? Stop the flow, do the work, move on. You know, when you stop the flow, take a look at what happens in reality. No more damage from the alcohol. No more damage is going to be caused from the alcohol, right? That's a big thing. Now, whether or not any more damage is caused is dependent not only on the alcohol, so you've stopped that. No more damage is going to be caused if you don't switch alcohol out for another drug or another destructive behavior. You know, putting something else in your body that creates damage to your organs that are already damaged, right? Now, the likelihood is that if you've been consuming this poison for any length of time, right, you're going to have some damage. How much damage depends on a lot of different factors. So, there's plenty of other things plenty of other things that you can put into your mouth that are gonna put a strain onto your already strained organs, right? Let's face facts, no heavy drinker is ever gonna go back to their organs being in pristine condition again, right? Your body can repair itself, thankfully, but there's a limit to what it can do, so you really have to take care, right? So let's just take your liver as one organ. You know, if you stop the flow of alcohol but switch out for something else, like a high sugar diet, there's going to be a problem there physically, depending on the damage that's already been caused from the alcohol. You know, that's the case for me. I have to watch what I eat, particularly things like that sugar and things that are going to damage my liver. I'm okay with that. You know, it's what I should have been doing all my life, right? And I'm lucky I've got that second chance to be able to do it. Now, once you stop the flow, then you have to apply yourself in making the improvements in your life. Most improvements won't happen unless you apply yourself in making them happen. You know, that's what we're calling doing the work, right? It's a simple process. Now, let me give you an example from my life, which I think can illustrate the process of doing the work. Now, I've done this in a lot of different areas of my life, so I'm just giving you one area at the beginning. You know, in the beginning of this journey, I was thinking, I stopped the flow of alcohol and my life has improved. What else can I stop? That was my idea. You know, that was as far as I could think. That was my experience level. So in the first year, I spent a lot of time reading about nutrition. It seemed like that obvious place to start. I really didn't know at the time where else to start, right? So I figured, I got rid of the alcohol, what else can I get rid of that will make my daily living healthier? What else can I change? Don't put the alcohol in your mouth, you know, where else can I apply that logic? So I read a lot of books on nutrition. I was veering more towards plant-based diets, you know, plant-based foods, right? That was where my reading was taking me, you know. Then in June 2013, it was just over 5 months since I stopped drinking, right? Something really bad happened. My dad had a heart attack. He just turned 80. He was rushed into hospital. My sister was in another hospital having a baby. So you can imagine that, the amount of pandemonium that was going on in our family. You know, he was, they told us that he wasn't coming back out. So like I said in other videos, I've got four brothers and four sisters and they're spread out all over the place. So we had to get everyone coming over because we didn't think he was going to come out. So everyone had to kind of come over and say goodbye to my dad. All the doctors I spoke to said he was unlikely to recover. His diet and lifestyle had contributed to his condition and they didn't think that he was going to come out of hospital again. So I remember talking to one doctor just outside his room, within eyeshot of my dad. And I looked over at him at one stage. He was lying in his bed. He had all these tubes and machines and all that kind of stuff around him. And he was just staring across at me. Now, my dad was a tough old soul, right? He always was a real man, sort of, I think, in the old-fashioned sense. Very tough, very hard-working, tons of character, loads of perseverance in his life. And that look that he gave me was, fuck that if you think that this is the end, pal, right? And he did come out of hospital. He did make some changes in his life, you know. I remember everyone being around him. We were all so delighted. I mean, it took him a while, but he did come out of the hospital. He made those sacrifices in his life and it bought him another few years. And because of that, because of what the doctors were saying to me, I pushed myself, I suppose, to, you know, stopping drinking alcohol is a radical thing. It can be viewed as a radical thing, but it's not really radical to stop putting the poison into your body. At the time, I was pushing myself to do the most radical thing that I could think of, which was to switch to veganism, or almost veganism, 99.9% veganism. My dad used to call me a vegan. Every so often I would have an egg, that kind of stuff. But for 8 years, I didn't eat meat, I didn't eat fish. I stuck to 99.9% vegan diet, like I said. And after 8 years, I'd read a lot more about nutrition. I had 8 years of the effects of the vegan diet on my body, right? And I decided that meat was more of a morality choice than a physical choice, right? And I don't want to go into too much in here, you know, because, you know, there's some vegans out there, and I'm not saying that it's a bad diet. It just wasn't a good thing for me. You know, my nutrition was then, and it still is, a work in progress, right? I've done a lot of experimentation over the years. I've had a lot of crazy diets. I've had, tried a lot of different things out. And it's been a lot easier to see the results without the alcohol skewing how I felt, you know. You know, a lot of the time, all you can go on is the way that you feel. So I could have shown you many different areas of my life where I'm doing the work, right? Doing the work to move on to something better. But it's a continuous thing. You have to look at this like a continuous thing that you're going to be doing for the rest of your life. Something that has to be done in life anyway. If you want to grow, if you want to work on yourself, you've got to work on yourself. You know, now, the best place that I can suggest that you start is to figure out the basics. Where you are right now. Who are you right now? You know, what are your values? What are your perspectives? Understanding where you are is crucial. If you don't understand where you are, how the hell are you going to figure out where you're going to go or where you want to go? And if you don't figure out truly where you want to go in life, you know, how can you plan anything, you know, if you've got no direction? So I always think that, you know, in terms of values are the most important things, and sometimes our values are not our own values, the stuff that we've taken on from somebody else. So I think it's an important first step to figure out what you value, what makes you happy, what makes you sad, what brings you pleasure, what gives you pain, and how are you going to set yourself real and tangible targets to aim towards, goals which are not just more of the same old thinking, same old stuff that's kept you drinking for all these years. You know, this journey is not about stopping drinking alcohol. That's just the essential starting point. It's the first step. First, stop the flow. Once you do that, everything else is moving away from the thinking that kept you drinking. Everything else is about changing what's going on up here. You know, so you can change what's going on out here. You know, what's going on up here is a lot to do with reactions to the world, or reactions to your behavior, reactions to other people. So a lot of that's got to change, you know. You marginally improve life just by stopping drinking alcohol. You marginally improve it because, you know, you've taken that poison out of your life. But if you really want to make massive progress in life, if you want to take your life to a different level, cliche, but you know, it's true. If you want to take it up a notch and enjoy your life and be contented with it, you know, to make massive progress in how you feel, positively feel, right, about yourself and your life, you have to go and change how you think about your life. You know, there's two mistakes that I see in people all the time when they're stopping drinking alcohol. The first is that they think that just stopping drinking alcohol is enough. It's not. It's nowhere near enough. Right? Second, people unplug from the alcohol, but they still believe that the journey has got anything to do with the alcohol moving forwards, and it hasn't. You know, that's part of our culture. that you're going to be an alcoholic for the rest of your life, fuck that. No chance am I going to be a, you know, you're consigning yourself to a straitjacket. You're getting rid of one straitjacket and you're consigning yourself and putting on another one. What bullshit, you know? So the journey starts with unplugging yourself from the alcohol. Once you stop the flow, then, and only then, can you start unplugging yourself from the alcohol habit. And finally, it's time to start unplugging yourself from a certain mindset. You know, whatever it is, it's instant gratification mindset, instant gratification thinking. You know, thinking that you can get anything in the moment that's going to give you something in the long term without work, right? That's what the alcohol is. That's what drugs are, you know. It's like, that's what people go into the doctors and taking medication to treat nothing but the symptoms, you know, instead of doing the hard work. You know, if you want to lose weight, stop eating the food, you know, get out and exercise. Don't go to a fucking doctor and expect the doctor to give you a pill, because that is not going to help you. Don't go and seek out surgery. I know there's some people that have to do that, but it just makes me mad, you know. You've got to get rid of the instant gratification thinking and replace that thinking with growth mindsets, with positive values. And then you turn both of these things into principles that you live by. You know, this is a key thing, right? It's principles. These are rules and laws and regulations and barriers and frontiers that you have in your life that you don't step across. You live by that no matter what. And you can't get your principles without first having the values in place, what you value in life, what you're trying to get in your life, you know? So you don't do these last two things without without getting away from the alcohol focus, without, you don't get rid of the alcohol habit, or you don't move on from that alcohol habit without first stopping focusing on the alcohol, if you get what I mean. You know, that's like going on a road trip somewhere and focusing in, instead of on the destination, focusing on where you've come from. You know, how, you're not going to get very far, you know. So it is what it is. You know, nobody said this stuff is fucking easy. Nobody said this is easy. But life is not. And if you want to get the best out of life, you've got to give your best in life, you know. I'm not crazy about pushing myself too hard, you know. Like, I know there's a line that I cross. If I cross that line, then I'm not enjoying it anymore. So, you know, there's limitations to this as well. But you have to figure that out, you know, and you only figure that out by doing it. You know, as normal, look, I'm going to finish it up today. I want to give you something for those who want to stop the flow and get going on this voyage, or for anyone else who's feeling a bit hesitant about taking that leap. And that's our beginner's guide to unplugging from alcohol. This is a very gentle introduction to some of the basic concepts and ideas that can really help to ease your mind about this journey, to make that decision a bit less daunting, to make the decision and the journey on the other side of that decision a bit more approachable. Okay, so to conclude today's video, you know, the journey from unplugging from the alcohol habit is not just about stopping the flow. It's the beginning of a much deeper journey, right? Exploring who you are and who you can become without this straitjacket holding you back. It's about embracing the unknown, challenging old habits, and shaping a life that is really going to resonate with you moving forwards, with who you truly want to be in life. And I think with the right tools, with the right guidance, and some shifts in your perspective, and sometimes it's not a huge shift that you have to make. Small shifts in your perspective sometimes can open up possibilities that are absolutely massive. So take the leap, stop looking back, focus on the next boundary. You know, living a life that you don't want to escape from is waiting just beyond that boundary. So listen, take care of yourself. Speak to you in the next video. Onwards and upwards, eh? Bye now.